Hello and welcome to TradingFloor.com's weekly macro view. 2011 has kicked off strong with manufacturing figures out in the US, increasing the interest in the first jobs data release of the year from the non farm payrolls. Will 2011 be the start of a strong recovery for the US? And in the Eurozone, the backbone of the region's economy, Germany, is showing signs of slowing down as weaker job figures have been reported. As we absorb the first rounds of macroeconomic data, what has 2011 in store for us? And with us, we have Mass Cofort, macro strategist here at Saxo Bank. Welcome, Mass.
Thank you.
So if we start with the data coming out of the US, we've got the surprisingly strong figures that have come out. What does that mean?
Well, if you look at the US economy, I think in terms of the recovery, it's split in two, because we see continually strong manufacturing data. As you say, yesterday's ISM manufacturing report was very strong, coming out at 57, as expected by consensus. We were slightly above, but overall a solid report. We saw the new orders index also rising, and as did the production index. So overall, it was a good report and shows that the manufacturing sector is still in a fairly robust recovery. In terms of employment, on the other hand, then you could say that it's in a much weaker recovery, as we've seen with the disappointing non-farm payrolls report last month, or at the beginning of December, and now we'll get the December report, the last one for 2010. And I think it'll show a continual trend of these 125,000 added jobs that we've seen the last couple of months, if we disregard the November report. So, but that's still only just enough to keep up with the population growth in the US, and hence just enough to keep the unemployment rate stable. So it's a split recovery, and I'm not sure that 2011 will show much stronger jobs growth than what we saw in the second half of 2010.
So over to the Eurozone, we've got a slightly different story. We've got obviously the turmoil that we've been talking about with the banking crisis, and we've also got German figures that have come out in terms of their job data, which is somewhat weaker. Can you give us a bit more in depth into that?
Yeah, it was a weak report. The last couple of months, we've seen the number of added jobs in Germany trend down, and now this morning's report was disappointing, as we actually saw an increase in the number of unemployed. Only 3,000 more unemployed people, but nonetheless, it was another bad report following a couple of poor net additions of 9,000 and 3,000 in October and November. So overall, we're trending down towards stagnation in the jobs creation in Germany, but I'm sure it's, from our point of view, it's still only a slight kink in the road, and we will return to add jobs in Germany. It's still the strong horse in Europe, and it will be one of the best performers in the Eurozone in 2011, we believe, both because they will continue to export, even though they'll be hurt by the weaker demand from other Eurozone countries, but also because they're becoming better equipped at sending their goods to China instead. So exports will slow, but not enough for the German economy to come to a complete halt. It'll still be solid growth.
So, I mean, if we have a look at the Eurozone, we have some unrest, obviously, that started with the Greek bailout. There's talk of impatience with patients being lost from Germany, being seemingly funding these failures in the other states. And we've also got a new member, Estonia, and there's talk of splitting currencies. What is this all shaping up? If we throw all that into the mix for 2011, are we looking at more volatility in 2011 for the Eurozone?
Well, we have our yearly outlook for 2011 out in a couple of days, and our headline for the Eurozone is this a year to forget or a year to remember? Because on the one hand, we could just have a slowly recovering economy in the Eurozone, like we saw in 2010, with meager growth and small additions to the to the workforce in the various member states. But on the other hand, it could be very exciting because we have all of this sovereign debt concerns, and we are sure that they will come back strongly this year with Portugal and Spain and also Italy. They all three have to refinance a large part of their debt in the first half of the year. So it could be very exciting, but the outcome we are not we don't believe will be that they'll split the currency into two. Rather, we'll see some kind of bailout of Spain, if it'll come to that, where the European Central Bank will step in, because right now the emergency fund that is set up right now is not capable of handling such a large country. So the ECB will probably step in.
Okay, Mads. Look, thanks for your time. And don't forget, you can keep up to date with TradingFloor.com for the latest in global macroeconomic reports. And you can also follow us on Twitter at TradingFloor.com. Thank you, and we will see you next time.